Welcome to the F Word at Claridge's.
On the menu tonight, the best brigade of the Sears are back to cook king crab tortellini, leg of lamb, and shepherd's pie made from my sheep. And hot chocolate souffle with mint chocolate chip ice cream. Plus, Johnny Vegas tries to pull a fast one in the recipe challenge.
The machine's making it for you.
Is it bollocks?
Cheating fuck-ups.
I don't work for you. You can't speak to me like this.
Hugh Furley-Wittenstall helps me cook the most exciting bits of my lamb.
This will certainly be the freshest set of brains I've ever worked with.
Ready?
And Ricky Gervais has a go at my extras.
He walked in the restaurant the other week carrying a stag. Who do you think you are? Four.
In. My northern stars, welcome back. Fucking well done.
Thank
How'd you,
you
feel?
Oh, absolutely fantastic.
Yes?
Out of this world with it.
Good.
Very excited
yes.
to be back.
Out there are some very discerning, demanding clients. Yeah? Customers that are expecting the best of the best. Yeah? Bloody good to have you back.
Thank you.
Yes?
To be here.
Let's get going, yeah? Right. Time for the starter, yes? King crab tortellini. Yes? Ready?
Yes, chef.
First, Susan. Yeah? We're going to kill the crab.
Oh.
Yeah, oh, don't look at it. Don't turn your nose up at that. Yeah, of course. Here.
It's a lot better.
Hold the crab.
Oh,
hold the crab!
No.
Take the crab! For God's sake, woman, let's go.
Oh, no!
Right, on here, please.
Oh.
Excuse me, if you're going to cook it, we're going to have to kill it first.
I don't mind you killing it. I can't touch it.
Susan, you're acting like a soft southern Jesse. Come on, stop fucking around. In there, through there. Knife on there, very carefully, and bang, straight through. And then we crunch throw through there, OK? Got to kill it quickly, OK? Say goodbye to him first.
What's he called?
You name him.
Bye, Gordon.
Through. Pull your hand through. Quick, straight away. That's it, good. Good girl, right. Excellent. And now we're going to take off the cluster. Through. Yes, there's one cluster. Hold it, please. Hold it. There you go. And there's your second cluster. In the water. Nice. Bring it back to the boil. Cook it.
Yes, chef.
Okay, good. Right, on order. First table, yes. Four covers, table two. Four tortellini, four lamb, four chocolate souffle.
Yes, chef.
Right, let's get on with the tortellinis, yes? We're going to serve two tortellinis per portion, yes?
Yes, chef.
Two thirds of a spoon, and we just egg wash half a tortellini. Judith, why do we do that?
To make it stick.
That's right. Up into your hands, push and nipple the air out. You ladies have got disciplined fingers, you can do that.
Yes, chef.
Okay, right. Let's just quickly go through the sauce together. Yeah, lemongrass, olive oil, yes? It's like a sort of tomato olive oil sauce, yes? Shallots in there. We've got our basil, our coriander, tomatoes in, and just leave that cooking away. Right, tortellinis, let's go. 1.5 minutes. Gently boiling water. Right, sauce out, ready to serve. Pasta's cooked, and then from there, onto the plate. King crab tortellini, we're a fresh tomato and lemongrass vinaigrette. You happy with those?
Yes, chef.
Yeah. Would you pay for them?
Yes,
go, please,
chef.
Yes. Table 10 there, JB, please, yes. Hugh Furley Whittingstall. Sandra?
Yes, chef.
Apparently you upset your mum last time you were on the F word, yes, by swearing, is that right?
Yes, chef, I had a pep talk before we left this morning, me and Susan. We was about to walk out of the door.
Imperial liver soap is not good. I had to have my mouth washed out with it after my mother saw that programme. She blamed you, chef.
Serious, why do I always get the blame? I don't mean to swear, you know that. It's the company I'm in.
Chef! You was.
Trust me, ladies, it's fucking great to have you back in
there.
Yes? That's nice. Let's go. Table 9 here. Very nice. Susan,
you're
in charge of the hot plate while I'm gone for 30 seconds, OK?
Yes, chef.
Keep this area nice and tidy.
Yes, chef. Does that mean I check them?
Hello, Johnny. How are you?
How are you doing, fella?
Nice to see you.
Yeah.
Yeah, enjoying your starter?
Yeah, fantastic. Yes.
So good to see you.
So good to be here, mate.
You're a very brave man. Later we're head-to-head on the recipe challenge. How do you fancy your chances?
I really fancy my chances. I think it's something that's beyond you. I think you've developed beyond simple good food.
Serious? Let me just show you where we're going to be cooking. Can I have a quick look at the kitchen,
right,
yes?
Okay, then.
I'll show you. Give you a head start so you're not so nervous.
Ladies!
When you get in here.
Hey, I don't pay you to chat. Work the room.
These ladies are also from Lancashire. Ladies, please. Johnny.
Yes,
Johnny.
Here we go.
Let's share the bus on. Let's go. Come round, come round, come round,
don't
Johnny.
Don't take no grief.
Nah. Huh? Come on,
this is Susan.
Oh, sorry.
Oh, hello, sir. Darling.
Judy. Nah. Yes.
Hello.
Sandra and Justine. Right. Right, Vegas, out of the kitchen. I'll see you for the challenge.
Light? What's your light? What's your light on your
name? As long as you don't burn anything, you're fine.
Yeah, yeah.
Johnny.
Don't cook for them. Cook for you.
Get out. Get out. Oh, get out.
Oh, girls. It's the Northwest.
Johnny Vegas, get out.
Jamie. You kick one cheek and I'll kick the other half of his ass.
Get Johnny Vegas out of this kitchen now, please, yes? Bloody hell. Like me, Hugh, the shaggy sheep farmer, doesn't like to waste anything.
I've just slaughtered my sheep and have invited Hugh Furley Whittenstall round for tea.
Yeah. Busy day at the abattoir?
Yeah, extraordinary day.
What have you got for me?
He's here to help me cook up a family feast with some of the more unusual cuts.
The most amazing brains and the breads.
Wow.
They are extraordinary.
It's a little while since I've cooked sheep's brains.
Really?
So you've got the two different types of sweetbreads, aren't there?
The long, thin one, obviously being the throat glands.
That's the and throat sweetbread, isn't
yep,
it?
Yep, and they're the heart. Yeah. Look at them, they're beautiful, huh?
Huh? Very tender.
This is really weird, having taken them out myself.
This will certainly be the freshest set of brains I've ever worked with.
Ready.
Now, do you think Tana and the kids will eat sweetbreads and brains?
Tana will definitely. Jack will definitely. The girls, I'm not too sure, you know that.
Good to have your garden back.
It will be, yeah, when it's all done, but, I don't know. It's really weird. Within hours, you start to miss them, isn't it?
Well, where is Gavin now?
Oh, he's up in Oxfordshire, roaming around and having some fun.
Born free. As free as the wind blows.
Has he still got his knackers?
Yes.
So he can be a breeding round.
I think he's going into happy retirement.
What an extraordinary turn of fortunes for him.
I know. Right, I'm just going to quickly sweat off these...
God, you're way ahead of me now.
Onions. No, don't worry.
You give me the bum job again.
I'm caramelising my onions in muscovado sugar. It gives a really nice, dark, rich, semi-spice. And then just going to put some balsamic vinegar in there and just sort of caramelise them, almost like an onion marmalade.
Great.
I'm going to put mine in slowly. I'm going to colour them slowly, get them nice and crispy, and then they'll take about 8 to 10 minutes to cook, OK? Look at that.
I'm going to lightly poach them. I'm going to pop them in now, actually. All I'm going to do is sauté the veg, poach the brains, and sauté the brains and put the two together.
Nice. Leave them to cool down. Fry off my garlic first. Slice the sweetbreads up. Now they've cooled down.
Just set nicely, these brains.
Nice.
It's like poaching an egg.
How lucky are the kids? Fried lamb brains and caramelised sweetbreads with a marmalade of onion, capers and vinegar.
You know what, I was going to do just the lightest sprinkling of cider vinegar on the brains themselves.
That is fucking pretty.
Right, sit down. Hey. Two very exciting dishes. Hey, Hugh, yours is?
It's brains with baby spring vegetables and mint.
Mmm. Yeah. And this is throat glands. And it's...
You're selling it so well, Jordan.
It's sweetbreads. Meg.
Daddy, I'm not that hungry.
Sweetbreads are absolutely delicious. The brains,
an unusual texture.
It's a very unusual texture. Very nice. I did like it.
I prefer the brains, yeah.
So do I.
You've already had seconds of brains. I can't believe it.
Hands up, you'd eat brains again.
Mummy!
Oh. Hands up, you'd eat sweetbreads again. Oh, no.
How about you dig a pond and get yourself a couple of crocodiles?
Yeah! Yeah!
Oh, God.
It's them crocodiles, giraffes.
I thought it was lovely. I thought it was presented very nicely and so many flavours coming through. I really enjoyed it, yeah.
Why are we eating these things with legs and shells? I'm sure it was happier in the thing that its flesh was already in. And with this, it can't even walk sideways. I feel like I've insulted the chef. Who is the chef?
Okay. Right, ladies, come over, please. Results, yes? Starters, yes? Were they happy?
Very happy.
Oh. Yeah? Right. Give me.
Here we go.
Thank you. Okay. The amount of customers that are happy to pay for their tortellini of king crab out of 50.
Oh, please.
46!
Oh.
Very good. Very, very good indeed. Well done. What happened before? What did they say?
too much pasta and not enough crab.
What?
He said that's what.
That's ridiculous. Too much pasta is a little disc.
Who is that, Johnny Vega?
Shall we go and see?
Yeah, it might be. Yeah.
Well done. Okay, the best so far.
Next on the menu, the Lancashire Lassies go commando.
What?
And my very special shepherd's pie proves a problem for Ricky Gervais.
Where's it going to end? You and Jeremy Clarkson in a helicopter shooting your cousins. They're so tasty.
Welcome back to the F Word. Time for the main course, my lambs. Now, I'm doing them two ways. First up, leg of lamb. Leg of lamb. The king of all joints. Sweet, tender, very rich and absolutely delicious. A must-have for every dining table. Get your butcher to bone it out and butterfly it, basically so you can tie it and roast it.
Hot oven. Season. Olive oil. Mint.
Use it in abundance. It's fresh, it's fragrant, smells amazing.
Goat cheese.
The mint perfumes the inside of the lamb, and the goat cheese just sort of makes the centre nice and creamy.
Garlic. Roll.
First of all, a big loop around the lamb. That keeps it all in shape. Get a nice length of string. Tie a knot right at the very top, underneath, and leave it coming out here. The secret of tying it, this shape, helps to cook it evenly, and look. Beautiful.
Rosemary. Season.
Gets the skin really nice and crispy.
Olive oil.
Stops the string from burning, so therefore it won't burst open when it's in the oven. And bingo.
Roast. 35 minutes. Rest. Carve. Mint vinaigrette.
That has confirmed it's definitely the king of roasts.
Roast leg of lamb with goat cheese and mint. Done.
Lamb nicely seasoned.
How long does this go in the oven for?
They're going to take
pink.
About 35 to 40 minutes.
Right.
In, yeah? Special lamb, as you know. It's going to be rested for literally the same time as it's cooked. So it's nice and pink, not too pink.
And it'll keep warm while it's resting all the time.
Absolute, definitely, yeah. Without doubt. So it's really important now to get some colour on the lamb. Yeah?
Uh-huh. Yes, chef.
Okay. Up. Okay, good.
Yeah, that'll be better.
Tonight I'm serving the lamb two ways. You've seen the leg, and this is the nation's favourite. Shepherd's pie, a great British classic. Absolutely delicious. Mince, vegetables, potatoes. Easy.
Olive oil. Minced lamb.
A little bit of colour on the mince, and it gets rid of that unwanted fat. Nothing worse than a greasy shepherd's pie.
Season. Great. Onion. Carrot. Garlic.
Once the vegetables are grated in there, they disintegrate and almost puree, adding great flavour. And that's the secret behind a really good shepherd's pie. It's all in the mince.
Worcester sauce. Tomato puree. Red wine. Thyme. Rosemary.
Right, now the red wine's evaporated, chicken stock in. I cook it out for 3 or 4 minutes, no more than that.
Potatoes. Mash. Season. Egg yolks.
Now, the secret ingredient, Parmesan cheese. Be quite generous with the Parmesan, because that's what gets it really nice and golden brown. That, now, deserves to sit on top of my mince. Good old-fashioned tip, just to keep my mum happy. Fork the top. 18 to 20 minutes in the oven. Beautiful. There, crispy topping. You can see why that deserves to be a great British classic.
Shepherd's pie, done.
46 out of 50 for the starter. Try and get 50 out of 50 for the lamb, yes?
Yes, yes, yes.
Yep.
Tonight, yeah, it's all about perfection, yeah? Let's do it out of respect for my lambs, yes?
Yes, Chef!
Judith and Susan, five portions away, please, yes?
Yes, Chef!
Let's go. Carrots take out and leave on the top there, yes?
Yes, Chef.
OK, let's go, ladies, yeah?
Yes, Chef.
Nice.
Let me put the lamb on there. Keep the round bit up to the top. Nice.
Carrots on. Right, nice. Not too oily, please, ladies, yeah? Service, please. Yeah, table six, please, yes? Ladies, I'm getting very nervous. You're very quiet. What's the matter?
We're concentrating, Chef.
Really, what I want to know is that Oliver Bird's told me that you go commando in the kitchen.
I was 21 years of age, for God's sake. I don't go commando anymore.
Yeah, but we just want you to know that we go commando
with you.
What?
We didn't even see that.
Look, we just saw you. What about you?
Oh, Jesus Christ almighty. It's like a pair of curtains. They're not knickers, are they? Oh, my God almighty. Oh. Now it's time for tripe, a forgotten food that I personally want to put back on the menu. Bloody hell. It may look disgusting, but I love a bit of tripe. Now, it's very cheap, very nutritious, but sadly these days, you've got to go through a hell of a lot of shit to get hold of it.
Tripe is the lining of a cow's stomach. It has been voted Britain's least favourite food, which I think is a waste. In my grandparents' day, everyone ate tripe, and I'm determined to put it back on the map.
I love tripe. I grew up with tripe. It's been in the family for years, and having lived in France and Italy, that's all we used to eat for staff lunch was tripe.
I've managed to get my hands on some fresh cow's guts and brought them to a tripe dresser before I can cook with them.
Peter, how are you?
Hi, good. Nice to meet you.
Likewise, good to see you too, my man.
Hey.
Now it's down to you to turn into something, some magical.
Here's your cake.
In 1900, there were 200 tripe dressers in Britain.
And your great-great-grandfather? No.
Now, there are only three.
And the smell. I mean, this place just stinks of tripe. What does the wife say when you get home?
She doesn't.
She doesn't?
She left.
She left. Oh, right. Shit.
Peter and I boil my tripe to make it more tender.
Look like you've been doing it for years.
And then bleach it to improve the colour.
It's hard to believe that's the same tripe, you know, in terms of, you know, how palatable it looks now.
Peter supplies Bob and Christine, who run a traditional tripe stall at the market in Accrington Stanley.
How are you, buddy?
How are you? All
good
right?
To see you. Well, Christine. Now, you've been selling for how long?
Their customers love tripe so much here they even eat it raw.
Now, how are you going to cook that? What are you going to do with the tripe?
The husband eats it as it is.
As it is.
With salt and vinegar.
Salt and vinegar, and he eats it cold.
Eats it cold.
Nice.
Out on the green part.
To find out who's actually buying Bob's tripe, I'm going to give him a hand on the stall.
Thank you. Oh, that's nice and cosy in here now, isn't it? Morning, madam. Would you like some tripe, my darling?
Yes.
What are you going to do with it? Vinegar?
Yeah, a lot of bit of lettuce and tomato.
And, madam, how old are you, please?
91 on Saturday.
91 on Saturday. Many happy returns
for
Saturday.
You.
Morning.
Morning, sir. What are you going to have this morning?
Jelly. Honeycrisp.
Is that for tonight's dinner?
No, no, actually. That's just when you get home.
That's just for a snack.
Yes.
Good man. Good man. The fact that I've just been here for the last 5 minutes and watching. Yeah, the customers come and pick up the tripe, how old they are. And in a way that, you know, there's not enough youth eating it. You know, tripe, ladies, is there anyone out there under the age of 30 who would like to buy some tripe?
Tripe's clearly got an image problem, and many young people haven't even tried it. So with Bob's help, I'm setting up my very own belly deli to reinvent it as a really tasty dish.
You like that, do you?
I like that.
Yeah, you like that, do you? Gordon's gut huts, yes? Right, Bob, what we're going to do is something sort of modern, okay? So pan-fried tripe, yes, with some lemon and parsley. If we get it looking fresh and modern, a lot more people are going to eat it.
Right.
Okay?
First of all, chop some onions and garlic and sweat.
So this is my way of doing tripe sort of fast, you know, like fast food.
Then toss the tripe in some flour and season with salt and cayenne pepper.
Well, just to make it a little bit more sort of tangy and fresh, you use vinegar, don't you?
Yeah.
I'm going to grate some lemon on there, yeah? And what that does, it just makes it a little bit sort of lighter, fresher and a little bit more zestier, yeah? And all I'm going to do now is fry it very, very quickly in some sunflower oil, OK?
Yeah, bro.
Season with fresh parsley and a squeeze of lemon.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Now we're ready. Who would like some tripe, please? Anybody here in Akron that hasn't eaten tripe, yes? Where are all the tripe virgins? You. Here we go. Why haven't you had tripe before, my darling?
Because it just doesn't look very nice at all.
Do you like it?
It's really nice, actually, yeah.
Yes, and it's fried
quick
in a pan.
As well. I think I might try it myself.
Yeah? Good girl. Hey, look at all these new customers you're getting. You like it? Yes? How old are you?
18.
That's what I want to hear. So we've gone from 90 to 18 this morning.
Very nice, actually.
Right, guys, come over. How are you doing? Now, this is Akron and Stanley's what? Under 11s. This dish here is full of protein. How old are you? 6. Do you like the tripe? Yes? Fantastic. It's a load of bollocks that people don't like tripe anymore because cooked in a modern way, they love it. Look at this lot. Next time you're out, get down to your butcher and get some tripe for dinner. It's delicious and healthy. Who would like some tripe? Now, I know you don't like fancy food. Enjoy the shepherd's pie.
Absolutely wonderful. I mean, shepherd's pie would be in, I think, my top 5.
Really?
So, oh, and that was lovely.
The mince for the shepherd's pie was from the lambs that I had in my back garden.
So, hold on. So they were basically your pets?
They weren't pets. You can't fall into that habit of allowing them to become pets, although they are very friendly to begin with, but then you've got to sort of distance yourself from them.
Yeah, but you say that. Well, where's it going to end? You and Jeremy Clarkson in a helicopter shooting your cousins. What? You go, I kept distance from them. I didn't really know them growing up. And they're so tasty.
You're so macho, aren't you?
I know, it's a
You're so tough. I'm glad you got your shirt on. You always have to show a bit of that, don't you?
No.
It's for the menopause of women. And go, oh, look, he's taking his shirt off. He walked to the restaurant the other week carrying a stag. Who do you think you are? Four.
hold on. No, but you enjoyed it, didn't you?
I did enjoy it. Obviously, I'd rather know that that animal had a wonderful life
Absolutely.
And was killed humanely.
Gavin escaped the slaughterhouse.
OK, you've given it a name.
Yeah, I know.
Why would you do that?
When you
buy it in Tesco's, there's not a name. They don't care. This is Bob. We killed Bob.
Okay. Gavin didn't die. Charlotte, unfortunately, got eaten.
What, a wolf?
Suspected puma, a wild cat, or, a humongous fox.
Where do you live, these pumas and humongous foxes?
No, it was at Beckenham Palace
Narnia.
In the back garden. What? No, but this is serious. Who does the cooking at home?
I do.
Not.
I don't know. No.
Ever?
No. Let me tell you why, Gordon.
Please.
I'm a genius. And I've got to save all those skills for other things. OK?
I thought Stephen Merchant was a genius.
That can't.
No, you're not just bloody brilliant at making people laugh. You're also bloody fantastic at making money. The DVDs, the podcasts, the Fanimals. Have you ever been tempted or swayed by doing an advert?
No, I'm not tempted, no. I got offered £1 million to do a gin advert in America when The Office broke in America. And my agent said, I know you don't do adverts, but I just run this by you. And I went, no, I can't. Because I just thought, if I said yes, I'd regret, so I said no. And he said, they've come back with £2 million. They thought I was haggling.
Oh, my God. I think it's because you haven't had the right product, OK? So I've got some items that I want you to have a look at and tell me how you would market them in an advert. OK, first thing?
Go on.
Flock. Chocolate bar. It's a delicacy in Sweden. How...
Aren't foreigners funny?
So how would you advertise it? How would you sit there and munch?
If it's a Swedish advert, it would be a really weird one, wouldn't it? It would be something like, you've had a plup. With a... What plup? Flitty bit of plup. Ooh. It would be something like that, wouldn't it?
What's that one that sexy rabbit used to advertise?
Cadbury's Caramel, no?
Yeah.
Yes.
Tell us about that.
Really?
Sexy rabbit. Can we cut that?
I've never had sex with any rodent. Actually, it's a lagomorph. It's not a rodent.
OK, this one, you like soups, don't you?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
OK, so it's a cock-flavoured bouillon.
Cock flavour. Excellent. Oh, God. Slurp it up. The great taste of cock.
Okay, finally, to wash it all down.
Perfect.
It's closer to Sweden, it's Denmark,
okay?
This would be...
Minge beer! No,
spunk... A shot of spunk vodka. I'm slightly squeamish to drink spunk...
Oh, God! The trouble that's very old spunk. That's that spunk that's been hanging around for quite some time.
Oh, how would you promote the Danish shot of spunk vodka?
That's the best spunk I've ever tasted.
Listen, really good to see you.
Yeah. Wonderful.
Keep the good work.
Thank you very much.
Jane, good to see you, my darling. Big kiss. Mwah. Good to see you.
I thought the lamb was excellent. Really nicely cooked, very tender, and I like the lemon zest on the top.
Well, it was delicious, the lamb, but it's a terrible shame about the goat's cheese in the middle of it. But once you'd scraped it out, it wasn't bad, actually.
The lamb tasted nice and tender, which is a sign that he hasn't had any stress and had a good life.
Right, results. This is quite special for me, yes, a lot of hard work. Months getting that ready, yeah, in terms of looking after them, nursing them, and doing all we can to improve that flavour, yes? JB, right, I thought you did a bloody good job, yeah? Clearly the most talented brigade we've had on so far.
Definitely.
However, yeah, they are the critics. They're your customers. And the amount of customers that are happy to pay for the main course...
Oh, no.
Damn.
That might not.
48 out of 50. Well done, well done, well done. That is not quite...
Good enough.
Perfect.
No.
Yeah.
Sweet.
There's room for improvement. JB, just out of interest, why didn't two pay? Who was
it? Too much meat and too much tomato in the pie.
JB, fuck off back to France, will you? Yes. Let's go. Dessert.
Next on the menu, I let my fanny loose in the kitchen.
Fuck off out of my kitchen, but only after you've done the washing up.
And 18 Stone of Idiot takes me on in the recipe challenge.
I have Gordon Ramsay parties. We all just sit around telling each other to fuck off.
Welcome back to the F Word. Now, time for me to take on 18 Stone of Idiots. Johnny, you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Nervous?
No, not at all.
Right, what are you cooking?
I'm cooking pizza.
Pizza?
Yeah, very simple, very rustic, food of the peasants. It's bringing working class into these kitchens. And giving them a taste of something substantial.
Something real.
Something that they can't just drive past on a Saturday night and watch people eat and go, how do those people live?
Perfect. Now, what's that? The secret machine, what is that?
This is my bread maker, stroker, dough maker, because it's the one thing that I do rely on.
I'm just doing a very simple pizza, fresh tomato sauce, and then top with some really nice Bayonne ham.
Just put my flour in, which is a very decent 00 Italian flour. What I'm going to do now is add the olive oil, but I haven't got a tablespoon measurer, but it's all right, I'm going to do it by eye, the crazy guy I am. I've got my live yeast here because I don't like the giant powdered stuff and you never get the right result with it. And start it mixing.
So you're not actually making your own pizza dough, are you? Putting it together, the machine's making it for you.
No, it's not. Well, it's
cheating fucker.
It for me. Is it bollocks?
Cheating fucker.
I don't work for you. You can't speak to me like this.
Johnny, be good.
I am being good.
I'm going to bring the water up the boil. Put my yeast in.
Oh, look, it be a machine. It's the work of the devil.
Whisk in the yeast that activates it. Touch of olive oil in there. Touch of salt, absolutely crucial. From there, flour into with a normal food processor.
So what are you using there, Gordon? Is it a machine?
Is
it a machine? Is it a machine?
It's a robot.
Does it plug in?
Hey, smarty pants, what are you doing with the tomato sauce?
Tomato sauce is just, it's just me, tomatoes, salt, tiny bit of sugar, oregano, and some fresh basil.
So Johnny's making a very simple tomato sauce out of tinned tomatoes. So I've just got some shallots and garlic and some basil here. I'm gonna fry off cherry tomatoes, a few sun-dried tomatoes. So it becomes a really nice, dry tomato sauce. Knead this together. Dough's kneaded. Right, that goes in. Should double in size. We'll knock it back and roll it out nice and thin. Right, how you doing, my man?
I'm going to make the pizza in three different sections.
Oh, really?
So I'm going to have one with me capers and me anchovies. And then I'm going to make a gorgonzola one in the middle just for the veggies. And then on the other end, I'm going to have
like
some
sounds like
a
four seasons, but you're using three seasons.
Yeah, yeah. I'm just spreading my options out, aren't I?
What is the most outrageous thing you've ever done on stage?
I did do a shit, but he deserved it.
On stage?
Yeah. I was in Liverpool. The guy came along to review it, and I went, oh, are you sort of the comedy review? And he went, no. Well, what do you do? He went, I normally cover pet shows. Well, what the fuck are you doing here? So I had somebody walk me around as if I was a dog.
And show me, you're on all fours.
Yeah. Like the proper... and then I just slipped my pants down and went and just squeezed a little. But then we had to tell them.
Did you wipe your ass?
I told them it was a prop. I was with my technician, pretending it wasn't real shit, and I went, it's not even real.
If you lose the challenge tonight, yeah, don't shit on me, OK?
No, no, I won't. Time is the one thing everybody fears. Time. It just ticks by with no
regards to years. Time. They say time can bring about a change. So this is my dough. I'm just going to roll it out, slacken it off a little bit, and just sort of get it really nice and pliable, and then roll it nice and thinly.
You're using a rolling pin?
I am using a rolling pin.
You big girl.
So tomato on first. A nice thin layer of tomato sauce on there. What kind of mozzarella are you using, the big ones or the little baby ones?
The big ones.
You copying me again?
Yeah, I just live, you know what I mean, to follow you. Yeah. If I could get clothes in your style, I would.
That's nice. That's
I have
very
Gordon
nice.
Ramsay parties. We all just sit around telling each other to fuck off.
And then finish with some really nice Parma ham. Right, ready?
Yeah, and it goes. There you go, the three seasons that you've been taking the piss out of.
Looks like fucking school dinners. Right,
no,
so.
It fucking doesn't. Okay, so, it's cut up, looks nice. Right, so then we've got that. We've got ham.
Yep.
Obviously, all this all over.
Yep.
Just ham and mushroom. And then we've got the gorgonzola. And then we've got the seafood.
Yes.
People have a choice.
Yeah.
In this world.
Up.
Right, good hot oven.
Yep.
In it goes.
Right. Johnny, they're in the oven now, yes?
Yeah.
10 minutes. Go and have a pint, come back, and you lose.
No, I'm going to stay and observe because...
You're paranoid.
No, I might need to put a little foil on. If since my base is a little bit thicker than yours and handmade,
right.
And made with passion, I might have to cover the top because I don't want the top to overcook before the base has got nice and crispy.
You mean you might have to get a takeaway?
No, it means I might have to do a shit on yours while it's in the oven.
Now it's time for dessert, a delicious hot chocolate souffle made by Ravinda, who last week I chose to be my new fanny. Ravinda, well done. Good to see you. You're now going to make the most amazing hot chocolate souffle. Teach the nation, yeah? Please don't fuck it up.
Thank you. So I'm going to show you how to make the most indulgent, decadent hot chocolate souffle.
Take 200 mils of milk, add 20 grams of corn flour.
When it's in a really yoghurty texture, you know it's kind of ready. And there you go, it's nicely thickening up.
Chop the chocolate.
Don't skimp on it. It needs to be about 60 to 70% cocoa content because you need to taste the chocolate in this.
Add 4 egg yolks.
It's really important that the chocolate is a little bit cooler, otherwise what you get is this horrible scramble from the eggs. My mother used to say, a clear work surface is a clear mind. Gordon's got all the dishes to do. I hope he's a good washer-upper.
Whisk the egg whites. Slowly add 150 grams of caster sugar.
Now remember, this is what's breathing the life into your chocolate mixer. You don't want to overwork the mixture. You don't want to get too enthusiastic. More washing for Gordon. Really voluptuous. You can see it almost heaving. It's really sexy.
Butter a ramekin and dust with grated chocolate. Clean the rim, otherwise your souffle won't rise.
So just leave it alone for 6 minutes, do whatever you want, have sex, read a newspaper. I don't know what you do in your 6 minutes.
The perfect chocolate souffle. Done.
Lovely.
Lovely.
Nice, nice, nice. I'm dying to get in there, you know that.
Is it good?
That. Absolutely delicious.
Fantastic.
Well done.
Well,
really
Gordon,
well done.
I've got one thing to say to you.
Yes.
Fuck off out of my kitchen, but only after you've done the washing up.
You're telling me to fuck off out of my own kitchen. Ravinda, you're like Susan, you still haven't got a boyfriend. Why?
Oh, well, what can I say?
It's
too many.
It's difficult, isn't it? You have to pick up the
same
age.
It's difficult to commit to one person as well. I find. What about you?
What are you saying? You're
putting... You find it difficult to commit to one person?
Yeah.
Why don't you guys go out on a double date, you and Susan?
Kind of fix us up with some nice fellas.
Yeah.
And
a nice little short-ass Frenchman like JB. Look over there.
JB's the most charming man I've
JB's
met.
JB's what?
Yes,
yeah.
Thank you.
He's the most what?
Charming man.
Charming?
Here.
He stinks of garlic. Look at him. Lovely. And again. stamp. That's amazing wrist action you've got there. Trust me.
I've well perfected done. It over the years.
Seriously. Ravinda, as they come out, you serve the table. Go straight to Johnny Vegas, yes?
Yeah.
Be careful, Johnny Vegas doesn't eat you. Okay, be very careful. Hands on here. Good girl. Off you go.
Hey, Johnny.
Hello.
Enjoy.
Oh, thanks,
Amanda. It is worth waiting for. I promise you, it's lovely.
Marry me!
Now it's time for Janet Street Porter to sink her teeth into Bernard Matthews.
Now, as you all know, I'm a little bit of a food snob, and this kind of thing isn't something I'd normally eat. Frankly, I'm surprised it's still on the shelves.
Cheery Norfolk farmer Bernard Matthews has had the smile wiped off his face by three huge food scandals. First came turkey Twizzlers, bursting with so much saturated fats that many schools dropped them like a stone. Next came these horrifying images, employees playing baseball with live turkeys. And then, just as you thought it couldn't get any worse, one of his farms was hit by bird flu. During the outbreak, it emerged that Bernard Matthews, that great British food institution, actually uses large amounts of meat from Hungary. But does he tell you that on the packet? Like hell.
Bernard Matthews, dinosaurs. Don't know where it's come from. Dinosaurs could have come from outer space. Bernard Matthews, jetters. Where have they flown in from?
Bernard Matthews is in the middle of a massive rebranding exercise, but being clear and honest about the country of origin is much more important than flashy logos or spin.
So it says, turkey breast meat is often referred to as a superfood because it's naturally low in fat and cholesterol. But where does it come from, Bernard?
Of the 21 packets I checked, only two gave the country of origin of the meat.
Well, you might think that Bernard's only doing what every other turkey producer does, but you'd be wrong. Take a look at this lot. Sainsbury's fresh British turkey. This, it tells you, product of Hungary, clearly marked. What's Bernard's problem?
Old Bernard's labelling isn't illegal, but it is potentially misleading. I think he's trading on his image as a Norfolk farmer to make his customers think all his turkey is English. But how does he do it? Simple. It's all about the packaging. All you have to do is make your product look English and not give any information about where the meat comes from. I'm going to make a turkey pie using meat from Brazil, Poland and Hungary and see if I can convince people it's actually English.
So I've made the filling for my pie and now I'm going to put the pastry on it and pop it in the oven. Here is my packaging. Turkey pie produced in England. This is perfectly legal. Now all I've got to do is see if I can flog them. Hi there.
Hello, Jenny.
Can I persuade you to taste some of my turkey pie?
Mmm, it's lovely.
If I told you that the meat in that turkey pie comes from Hungary, Poland and Brazil.
Yeah, I'm not going to catch nothing, am I?
The box is very misleading.
When you look at that box, where do you think the meat in that pie comes from?
I would think it comes from England.
But if I put this box on sale and it said meat from Poland, Hungary and Brazil, would you buy it?
More than likely not.
Where do you think it comes from?
Turkey.
I think we consumers have a right to know where our meat comes from. One person who agrees is David Clark from Red Tractor, the UK's leading independent food assurance scheme. If there's a Red Tractor on a piece of meat, you can be 100% sure it's British and carefully reared.
Do you think it's important that when people buy food, they know exactly where it's come from?
Absolutely. I mean, that's why we have a clear statement of country of origin within the logo. Therefore, the consumer cannot be confused.
I think what I'm going to do is go to Mr. Matthews and ask him why he won't sign up to your Red Tractor scheme.
I think that's a good idea.
I wrote to Bernard Matthews explaining my concerns, asking him why he doesn't label where his meat comes from and demanding that he signs up to the Red Tractor scheme. 2 weeks later...
Here I am in central London. I've been summoned to meet Bernard Matthews, chief executive.
Hi.
Bernard doesn't get out much these days, so he sent his right-hand man to answer me.
I have threatened to serve Bernard Matthews with a food asbo.
Right.
And he'll be my second one after Prince
Charles. I saw your first one.
Now, Bart, I've got a whole bag full of packaging here, but I'm looking for where this turkey comes from.
We've not realised it's that important. In fact, we would welcome all of the origin of meat to come on because we'll find that we still have the vast majority of our stuff comes from the UK.
But hang on a minute, Bart. On the 5th of February, Bernard Matthews' company said all our turkeys are British.
All our turkey eggs come from our hatchery and from our laying flocks, which are ours, in Norfolk.
Yeah.
So all our turkeys are. Now, those eggs may go to Hungary to be born, but to be reared. But the vast majority of all of our turkeys are in Norfolk and reared in Norfolk.
When you say all our turkeys are British, does that mean that the ones who are in Hungary, their mum and dads are British?
Certainly, yeah.
But they're living in Hungary?
Yeah.
So they're Hungarian turkeys?
The vast majority of our products come from the UK and we're going to very clearly signpost those products that are British. And what we're doing on the back is we're going to take a lead on it and describe when products are British, it'll be very clearly stated it's British. And we've got agreement from Red Tractor, so we can use that
logo. So you are going to put the Red Tractor sign, starting when?
It will be by the beginning of September.
So when it says, under Bernard Matthews, it's going to be in here?
Yeah, made from turkey from our own farms or from wherever else.
So that's a promise?
Yeah.
By September the 1st?
We'll get them on.
OK, it's a deal. OK. Ta.
Hello, Janet.
Hello, Gordon.
Nice to see you, my darling.
Thank you.
You look great.
Thank you, I dressed up the carriages.
First of all, congratulations.
Yeah, I do feel a real sense of achievement.
You made Bernard Matthews, Mr. Bootiful, eat his words. Well done.
I think they were scared of us. That's a brilliant thing.
And what they agreed to do? What exactly
is he
doing?
Well, the amazing thing, they're going to sign up to the Red Tractor scheme. So all the meat that they use, that is bred on farms in the UK, is going to have the Red Tractor.
Good.
And meat that comes from abroad is going to have the country of origin clearly labelled on the packet.
Bloody good news.
So they're going to be far more honest, which is
fantastic. How is he going to stick to it? What's he going to do to make sure?
He promised me that by September this year, they will change their labelling on their packaging.
And if he doesn't stick to it, what are you going to do to
go out to Norfolk and deep fry his turkey twizzler? I will. I'll go out there.
Bloody well done. I think he was scared more of you as opposed to the asbo. You know
you're not scared of me, are you, Gordon?
Beautiful. I'm not scared of you at all, my Janet. Take care, my darling.
See
great
ya.
Lipstick.
Next on the menu, will heavyweight Johnny Vegas knock me out in the recipe challenge?
Look at the choice, look at the array of that.
Claridge's.
Looks nice.
B&B in Bognor Regis.
And will the girls do Lancashire proud?
How do you think we did?
50.
I hope so, you know that. Yeah. I really do.
Welcome back to The F-Word. Now, time to find out who is the Michelin star chef and who is the Michelin man. Are you ready?
Yes, I am ready.
Let's go, big boy.
And I'm confident.
What are you finishing it with?
Well, a bit of olive oil.
OK.
Oh, my anchovies! Whoa! Nearly forgot. I want the fresh ones from the bottom.
Look at that. Hey, it looks nice. Here's my baby coming out. Holy mackerel, look at that baby. Woo! A little bit of basil on the top.
I think yours screams Michelin, mine screams family.
I think yours screams cheese shop.
You know what I do with it?
Go on.
It's late night phone calls for the rest of your life. Hey, do you remember that time we did that pizza? Johnny, fuck off.
Look at that. Look
now
at that.
Then, now then, look at the choice. Look at the array of that.
Claridge's.
Looks nice.
B&B in Bognor Regis.
Right.
Right then.
Oh, I like that sound, that crispy sound.
Just to even it up.
Right. Hey, that looks nice. Right, listen.
Yeah, you see how I've juxtaposed the sizes?
Yeah, I know, but you've got three seasons and four bits of pizza.
Yeah, it's based on French architecture. I know that taste-wise, that'll be phenomenal.
Good
luck. I know that, you know, that's why you earn money from it. That's why I'm 18 stone.
Right, JB, off you go.
Entertainer.
Yes, entertainer.
Right.
Off you go.
Yep.
The Three Seasons by Johnny and Clarity's Pizza by me.
Jim bought a rehearsed, two coughs when you put his down. Money's exchanged ends and you know the brown envelope in the garage.
Dish number one.
Ooh.
And the dish number two. Bon appétit.
This one first, yeah?
Yeah. Looks crispy.
Yes.
Mmm.
I always like sun-dried tomatoes, real tomatoey kick. Not too much cheese either. Okay. It's square, isn't it? It's a very different
very
shape.
Very square.
And a much
thicker base.
Base, yeah.
Cheesier, for sure. It's actually crunchier than the other one.
Mm. OK, big boy. I hope you're not going to make a monkey about me, Johnny B. Johnny B. Johnny
come
B.
Come on, come on, come on.
Right, come on.
Okay. Good to Papa.
No, very close. Very, very close. It's a 3-2-2.
It's a 3-2?
Yeah. So it's very close.
Come on.
Yeah.
Come on.
Okay.
So the winner is.
You're looking at me, which is telling me that you're going to say him. No. Not as if you're trying to tell me whether you charge your best.
It's you, Gordon.
Oh, yes! Right, boy. Get in there.
Well done.
Thank fuck for that. 3-2, so it was close.
I had money on myself.
Hey, you can hold your head high, my man. That was fucking delicious.
Oh.
Cheesy, but delicious.
Oh, yeah, whatever.
Do me a favour.
Well,
take your pizza and fuck about the kitchen.
Never darken this restaurant again, big man.
And don't shit on the kitchen floor on the way out.
No, I'll save that for the restaurant.
Hey, well done, big boy.
Now, for all you animal lovers out there.
Yes. Right, fuck it, I'm going to open a pizzeria. Last two, careful now. Last two tables, and I'll dust. You put them on, yes? Here we go. And away.
OK, we got 2 sixes.
Thank you. Hey, JB.
Yes.
Thanks for doing your job.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Yeah? I know in France, they only want to work fucking 32 hours a week, but thanks so much for coming.
Yes.
Yeah? Excellent. Susan,
yes,
are you giving
chef.
JB the eye? Are you trying to mince him up?
No, because we like John, whatever he's called.
John Baptist.
John the Baptist, yeah. That's right. No, it's called John Baptist.
Yes.
Good girl. Thank you, my darling.
We told him that you told us he was gay.
He's not gay.
You're about as discreet as fucking Johnny Vegas. He's definitely not gay.
Chocolate souffle was perfect, absolutely amazing texture, just really nice and gooey and choppy in the middle. And the mint chocolate chip ice cream was a kind of a throwback to my childhood, so like quite sort of retro little touch on the side, so it was lovely.
I thought the dessert was delicious and definitely worth £5.
Really beautiful, melt in the mouth, really, really lovely, actually.
Give me the results, please. Now, ladies, Justin. How do you think we did?
50. Yes, chef.
I hope so, you know that. Yeah. I really do.
We worked hard, we did.
Some of them went out a little bit lopsided. However, the flavour was fantastic. For dessert. Oh, shit. 50 out of 50! Yes! Hey! That is perfection. Well done. 50 out of 50 for dessert. Yeah. Bloody good news. Yeah. Now, will you do me a favour?
Yeah.
Hold on. Come with me to the dining room. Let's go. Out. Let's go. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, your chefs for this evening, yes? The Langsy Lassies. Well done. Hey! Get in there. Right, go say hello. Get in there. F-Word Series 3, done.